Hi and welcome to this tutorial where I'm going to show you how to use the Age Gate widget with the Plus Addons for Elementor. With this widget, you'll be able to filter all users based on legal requirements. For instance, you can implement an age restriction for when your users must be over a certain age, like over 18 or 21, or based on their birth date, in which case their age will be calculated automatically, or simply by offering them a yes or no type of answer. I'm Dave, and I'm bringing you this guest tutorial on behalf of the Plus Addons for Elementor. Make sure to subscribe to their channel, that way you won't miss out on a single update. Now, let's dive right into it. And the first step is to make sure that our widget is activated. And for this, we go into the Plus settings, Plus widgets. In the search box, type age. And next to our age gate, you have a toggle switch. Make sure this one is turned on, just like that, and then click save. Now we have to clear the cache. We go into performance, purge all cache, click OK, and that's it. All done already. And now that our widget is activated, we can insert it in an Elementor page. Once you have your page open, to find your widget, simply scroll down, and you'll find all your Plus Essential add-ons right here, including Age Gate. Or you can go into the search widget and type age, and here is our Age Gate widget again. Now you can add the Age Gate widget to an existing page or a blank canvas. So let's add this to this page. All you have to do basically is drag and drop it. Now as you can see, our widget is displaying on top of the content of our page. So if you're planning to edit your page and its content, you'll have to use this feature here, backend visibility. And you can disable it, and now you can see we have a discrete preview of our widget. Now, if you're working on the widget itself, you'll have to re-enable it so you have a preview of the widget itself. Now, we can choose among three different methods. So we have age confirmation. In this instance, you'll have to confirm that you are over a certain age before you can access the website, so maybe over 18 or 21. We have birth date. In this instance, you'll have to enter your birth date before you can access the website. And then we have Boolean. So basically, Boolean gives you the choice between two different options. It's either true or false, yes or no. So whatever statement you have here, your visitors will have to agree or disagree. Now let's go back to our age confirmation. And now let's go and tweak all the content right here. So we go into content. And our first option is whether or not you want to display your logo. So you can enable this or disable this. If you want to enable it, you can select your logo. So click on this and you can either upload a new file or go into your media library. So let me select this one here for now. We can insert it and there you go. We now have our logo and then we have our title. Again, you can enable it or disable it. You can change the content here. So this one, age verification, maybe you want to have something different, maybe confirm your age, and then the description. And again, you can disable it or enable it. And then you can change the content right here. So maybe your website, instead of 18, maybe it's 21, and you can change the value right here, or you can change the whole text altogether. It's really up to you. And then we have our mandatory field here. So you have to confirm that you're over a certain age. You'll have to tick that box and it will reveal this button here. So to change this text here, we go scroll down a little bit. And here I can confirm that I am. And instead of 18, we're going to put 21 years old and over. And then we have our button here. So at the moment it says enter. Now we can change this value if you want. So maybe you want to say access website instead. And then we have the button icon. So you can see you have a small icon right here. So you can decide whether or not you want to display it. So maybe text only or an icon with text. Now you can select which icon you want to display as well. So just click on this. And if you scroll down, you can see there's many, many to choose from. So let's go maybe with a check mark for now. Let's insert. As you can see, we now have a check mark instead. And you can decide whether you want to display this icon the front or at the end of your text. So you have prefixed or postfix. And finally, we have our extra info here at the bottom, and you can change the content right here, and you can decide whether or not you want to display it. Now we have the freedom to align our text wherever we want it. So for instance, it could be to the left, to the right, or center, and the same for the rest of the content. So you can have to the left, to the right, or centered. And you can apply those settings depending on the type of device as well. So it could be on a tablet or a mobile phone. Now let's discover our extra options. So as you can see here, we can add a background image or a right side image. So let's go ahead with the background image first. So let's enable this. And as you can see, the background has changed now. So we can change our picture and go select our own picture. So we're going to select a file. And let's select this one here, maybe. People at a party. Insert. And then we have the background position. So this is how you want to display your image, the background image. So basically this will only apply if your background image is larger than the screen on which it is being displayed. For instance, center, which center the image horizontally and vertically. Now you might want to add an overlay color. So let's see the results here. If I click on this and select a color, maybe a purple, as you can see, our background is fully opaque. But we can change the opacity as well. So use this slider here. And as you can see, you can increase or decrease the color range just like that. So this would be absolutely fine. So this is how you add an overlay color. And now let's add a right side image. So let's enable this. And as you can see, this has been divided in two different sections. So we have our content here and then our image to the right hand side. So let's add an image. So you can select file. Upload a file and then import. And now we can click insert media. And there you go. As you can see, now we have a few bottles of alcohol right here. And this is why you need confirmation of your age, because you have to be over 21 to consume alcohol. Let's disable this for now. And now we have our cookie. So when someone will tick this box, this checkbox, it will save a cookie on their computer and web browser. So basically, if they want to access your website later on, they won't have to confirm each and every time. And you can set an expiry limit as well, maybe for instance, 10 days. And as always, don't forget to save by clicking update. Now let's have a quick preview. So we click on preview changes and let's put this to the test. So we can see here, I confirm that I'm 21 years old and over. So let's click on this. Now we can access our page. Now let's stylize our content here. So for this, we're going to style. And the first is our logo. So as you can see, the logo is a bit small at the moment, so we can increase that as well. So you can see I can increase the size of our logo very easily by sliding this to the left or to the right. Now to demonstrate the border radius, I'll have to change this picture here with one with a darker background. So let me do this now. And now we can add a border radius. So let's start with 25. And as you can see, now all our corner edges are rounded. So we can increase that, maybe 50. The bigger the value, the more rounded the edges will be. And then we can add some margin as well. So all around the image, or just top and bottom, for instance. So let's say if you wanted to add a bit of spacing between the image and confirm your age, we unlink all of these values and just going to add a little bit at the bottom. So let's add 50, for instance. And now we have a bit of spacing. So let's say maybe 30 would be just about perfect. So you can select the typography. So basically the typography is the font. So if you click on the small pencil here, you can choose different fonts. So let's say we're going to go for Poppins. And then we can change the size as well. So let's make it big enough. Confirm your age, maybe 35, and we can change the weight. So that's the thickness basically of our font. So this is ultra bold, black, and then bold, and then you can have it thin as well. It's really up to you. So let's keep it maybe 900, confirm your age, and you can transform as well. You can have it all uppercase, lowercase, capitalized, or normal. So let's go maybe in all uppercases. And you can stylize this as well. You can have it italic, maybe. And then decoration. So you can underline, you can overline, you can have a strike through, or nothing at all. So let's maybe use underline for now. This is absolutely fine. And you have the line height and the letter spacing as well. So this is when you have more than one sentence, obviously. So this doesn't apply to us at the moment. And of course, you can apply a padding or margin. So basically add a spacing. So what's the difference between padding and margin? Well, a margin is the space around an element's border, while padding is the space between an element's border and the element's content. So that's the only difference between those two. And of course, we can change the font color. So let's select this and let's go for red, maybe confirm your age. Now you can have it for normal or hover. So if someone hovers on top, it will change color. So let's say it could be black. And then if you hover on top, it will turn red. So let's put this to the test, just like this. So if you were to hover, it would change color. Now let's stylize our description. So this is, you must be 21 years old of age to visit our website. So again, we can change the typography. You can select our font. We can increase the size of our font. So let's make it a little bit bigger like this, maybe. And then maybe a bold font as well, just like that. That's just perfect. And then again, you can add a padding, a margin. You can change the color of the font in itself. Now in the description, you also have the option to add a background. So we can select the paintbrush and we're going to select a color. So let's select maybe a grayish color like this. So as you can see, now we have a background color that's been added behind our text. And we can even add a border. So we're going to add a solid border, maybe a dashed one. Dashed border like this. And we can change the width of our border. So let's say maybe 15px. No, that's maybe too big. Let's say 5px. And then we can change the color of our border as well. So let's go maybe with a reddish color like this. And we can change the border radius so we can round this as well. So let's go maybe with 25. There you go. So this way you can emphasize the message even further. And you can even change the font color if you wanted to and make it red as well. So this way, no one is going to miss that message. And you can even have a gradient background if you wanted to. So you can have the first color and then the second color. So let's select a brighter gray, maybe whitish like this. There you go. So now we have a gradient background. And the same applies to checkbox, icon, and text. So here you can change the typography again. So it's up to you to change this around. So let's select maybe a thinner font for this. Okay, just like that. And we can change the font color. Let's go with a jet black. And that looks absolutely fine. Now let's configure our button here, access website. So first button. So we can change the font. And we can add a padding. So basically all around this text here, we can increase the padding because our button looks a bit small at the moment. Maybe you can add a bit of padding. So maybe you can start from 10 and we're going to increase slowly. So maybe like that, this would be absolutely fine. And maybe we can increase the right hand side, maybe up to 40 and do the same on the left 40. There you go. And obviously we can change our background color and text color as well. So let's go ahead with this. So we can select the paintbrush. We can select a color. So let's go maybe with red or maybe black. Let's go full black. And now we can change the color when we hover on top. So if we're going to hover and we can select a color. So background color right here, add a color. And maybe we're going to select a brighter gray, maybe just like this. So as you can see, if we hover now on top, it will reveal a different color. And you can even do the same for the border color. So you can add a solid. We're going to put 3 again. And we're going to put a brighter gray like this. And now if we have a quick preview, you can see now it is displaying evenly. Now we can even tweak the icon here. So we're going to first button icon. So we can change the size, can make it bigger or smaller. I think 19 or 18 maybe would be fine. And then we can have an offset. And you can change the color. So maybe you want it to be black or red, but let's keep it white for now. And then we can change the size of this text here. So let's go into extra info. So it's a bit too big, I think, for the moment. So I think we should make it maybe smaller. Maybe just like this. And we can change the font and put something a bit thinner. So we can keep Roboto, but we can change it to maybe 300, just like that, because this is just for agreeing to the terms and condition. And you can change the color as well if you wanted to. You can have it in red, but I think black is fine as well. And finally, we can configure our box in itself. So as you can see, the first option is the box position. So if you enable this, you can set it automatically to the left, just like this. And you can decide if you want it to be further away from the left, maybe by 10 pixels, 30 pixels, 35 pixels, or even percentage. So maybe 10% from the left. And you can do the same on the right hand side. So pixels from the right hand side. And you can have it always 45 pixels away from the right hand side, or in pixels again. And this basically will allow you to reveal the background picture. And of course, you can set these for different types of devices. So it could be for tablets, and you can have it for mobile phones as well. Let's disable this for now. And obviously, you can change the box width and height. So by default, it's 500 by 400, but you can increase the height slightly if you wanted to. And you can do the same with the height. So clearly we can add a background color as well. So in normal mode or when we hover on top. So let's add a color now. So let's just select a plain color in the paintbrush. We're going to select a color. So let's go maybe with a bright purple maybe. That would fit with our background. This would be fine. And then obviously we can add a border as well. So let's go with a solid border. We're going to make it maybe 5 pixels in thickness. We're going to select our color. So let's go again with the purplish color. Maybe this shade would be fine. And then we can have the border radius as well. You can round it up just like that. And then we can even add a box shadow. So let's click on the pencil. And then we can add the shadow horizontally. As you can see now, it's being shown here by the side. So let's go maybe 20. And the same vertically, maybe another 20. You can choose the blur type, so darker or not, more visible. So maybe 9 or 10 would be absolutely fine. And you can do the same for all these methods. So let's go into birth date now. The only difference with this one now, if you go into content, obviously you can change all the settings like we just did. But there's one additional setting here is the minimum age limit. So basically you can set the minimum age limit. And this will be calculated automatically once they enter the date. And finally, let's configure the Boolean. As you can see, we have a choice among two different options here. We have access website or don't access the website. And to change these settings, obviously you can change all the settings like before. But you can also change your buttons here. So instead of access website, maybe you could have yes, I agree. And maybe you have no. So there you go. This is how you can implement the Age Gate widget on your website. And you will agree that it does add a lot of interest to your web pages. If you have any questions, please post them in the comment section below. Again, my name is Dave, and it was a real pleasure to present this tutorial on behalf of the Plus Addons for Elementor. And make sure to subscribe to their channel so you won't miss out when new videos are being uploaded. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next video.